reciproco tra voi è già una realtà.
Trade Center, make some noise! I'm Gio from Manila, Philippines, and with me today is Cheska. Okay. Relax. I'm relaxed. I'm gonna call her. Wait. 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 Just relax. Oh, here it
hello,
is.
Hello, hello.
Cheska, where are you?
I'm on my way. I'm on my way.
Still, program starts at 4.
When they say 4, they don't really mean 4.
But they're all here.
What?
Yes, all 6,000. Say hi.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Cheska, you have to be here. What will we do? We have to follow the script.
Okay,
you know, we have a script. Okay. What will we do?
Well, because you know, the traffic here in the Philippines is crazy.
But they did not feel it.
Hi, guys. What's up? Wait a minute. We're supposed to have two other hosts here.
Yeah,
you were rushing me and they're not here. I mean, hi.
Well, they were waiting for you, but they're already here. Let's call in Ana Clara from Brazil and Louis from Burundi.
Hey!
Hello, guys!
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Everybody is so hyped.
You know, they actually went. They
Louis. Yes, long time no see.
Okay.
Yeah, nice.
Hey, anyway. Clara. Last time we meet, it was in GenFest 2010.
Yeah, we were together in Europe, where all the GenFests were held before until now.
So this is the first GenFest outside Europe, and the first day in Asia.
Yeah, the first GenFest in Asia!
Wow!
But instead of telling you, why don't we just show them?
Yes, of course.
Let's watch it.
Back in time, starting in 1973. Go!
Right.
Thank you. we go beyond. We go, we go, we go beyond. We go, we go beyond. We go, we go, we go beyond. We go, we go beyond. We go, we go, we go beyond.
My name is Gio Francisco from Manila. Magandang hapon sa inyong lahat!
I'm Anna from Brazil. Oi, gente!
Woohoo! My name is Lewis from Burundi!
Okay.
So, how are you all guys doing? You good? What about people from the back? We still see you over
there.
We can
see you.
Nice, that's nice. So let's get to know the people in our audience. Can I hear the people from North, Central, and South America? Woo, 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 woo.
My people from Africa!
Yay. What's up? My homies from Europe!
Nice. Shout out to Asia and Middle East! Yeah! Yeah!
People from Australia!
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! Woo! All right, do we have anybody from Antarctica?
Oh, no, Antarctica. Come on. No.
You never know.
It's okay.
I told
We're your
you
friends.
Okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
All right, anyway, we'd also like to give a shout out to our friends from Risho Kosekai. And Living Peace International.
Hey.
Nice. Also, our friends from Association Non de la Guerra.
Yeah. Oh, they're here.
And Association Hindu Shanti Ashram. Yeah.
Yes, they're here.
Oh, hi.
Yes,
hey. Hello.
And also from there, from Brazil, Fazenda da Esperança.
Yay.
Yeah.
Now that we got the people with our audience, let's get to know the people on stage.
Okay.
Yes, let's call Kokoi to introduce the band. Kokoi.
Hey, what's up, Kokoi?
Kokoi.
Kokoi.
Kokoi. Always late. I wonder why.
Who's his friends with? I think his friends with.
Don't take it as an excuse for your being late. It's okay.
No, it's a thing, really.
No, it's not.
Traffic and all that stuff. Kokoi, are you coming?
Kokoi.
Okay. I don't think he is.
You can help us to call Kokoi.
Oh, there you are. There you are.
Kokoi. Kokoi. Kokoi.
He's here.
Kokoi.
Kokoi. Kokoi. Kokoi. Kokoi.
Okay.
You are very bad making us wait, huh? I don't like that.
Oh, yeah, you did that to me also?
Shh.
Okay.
Okay.
Teka, ano nangyari dito?
Introduce daw the band.
Introduce the band? Abale, ako nga po pala si Kokoi.
Oh, okay, wait. I think we need translation here. Can someone help us with the translation?
Translation? Oh, someone signed up already.
Yes, let's come in. Yes.
Thank
you.
Give it a shout for Connie.
Wow, okay.
Okay, take it away.
You talk. Okay. Magandang hapon sa inyong lahat! You talk. Kamusta kayong lahat?
Okay, that's nice.
You know, parang gusto ko rin matuto ng lingwahe niya eh.
Okay, go ahead.
You teach me how you speak. How you say I love you. Mahal kita.
Easy.
Yeah.
Okay. They clearly understood each other, guys.
Okay. Thank you so much. That was a very strange experience.
Thank you, you guys. We're so full of talent here.
Wait, hold on. Weren't there supposed to be more than three vloggers?
Yes, you've been watching us on social media. Yes, actually, there are supposed to be others.
Where are they? What?
I don't know.
Where have you been?
Other vloggers? Are you here?
The vloggers, where are you?
There they are!
Hey, right there.
What's up? Kiara. Where have you guys been?
We are here.
Yeah, we are here.
Guys, wait. First, let's take a selfie.
Of course.
You wouldn't be a vlogger without us. Okay. You really had to wait until right now.
We're going to wait for you to do that
in the middle of the program. You know?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I just go back from Dumaguete.
That's nice.
I was with them. So we ran the Amazing Race, and we did the Dula Tabay 360. We also did workshops and cultural activities, and also we have time to see the nature and to enjoy the scenery. It was really great.
Ooh. Nice.
Yeah, I also just heard from a group who came from Masbate. Yeah, it was a very special occasion because they didn't have the permission to go there. It was off limits, so they had to get the permission. And they went and helped in the prison, in the hospital with the children. And they also had time to see the nature and the beauty, and it was amazing.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Wow.
You know what? I heard a group went to Hong Kong, and there they got to witness... Yep. They got to witness firsthand the disparity between the rich and the poor of the city. They also talked with the bishop about the status of the church there and the spirituality of the people.
Do you have any picture of this event?
Yeah, I think I got a few.
Wait. Better, let's watch the video.
Okay.
Thank you.
You know, back in Brazil, I have a friend who lives in the same city as me. Every day he go out and see so many needy and poor people. So at his work, he receives a small amount of money every day where he can buy food in the canteen. So he thought, maybe I can buy a small snack every day.
Here we have a small interruption in the broadcast of the GenFest from Manila. Let's hope that we can return to Manila in a few minutes. Let's ask ourselves just briefly what the GenFest is, although obviously many among those who are listening perhaps have been to GenFests over the years. So the GenFest is about being a new generation, and it's for young people between the ages of 18 and 30 who want to work for a united world, and they share the ideal of Kiara Lubick, who God inspired to build one human family where there was equality, solidarity, reciprocity and mutual edification, so as to build a truly human society where there is love amongst all its members. So some people might say, but is it worthwhile today talking about a united world? And the young people want to say, yes, we believe that it's possible. We might instinctively say that we've never been further from a united world than we are today, given the number of wars and conflicts and the sort of fragmented nature of society. Yet we need to recognize that for the first time in history, our different peoples have, all the different peoples in the world have the opportunity to connect with each other, to speak to each other, to collaborate together in a way that is completely different from what was possible in the past. And of course, the mobility and migration are creating new context for everyone, whereby we need to open our eyes and see who we have alongside us and recognize that person as a brother or a sister. Therefore, the young people for a united world, youth for unity, who are part of this new generation, they want to consider diversity as a strength. Certainly, they recognize it's a challenge, but they consider it as a strength, as a stepping stone, as an opportunity for dialogue and mutual understanding. They don't believe in the theory of the clash of civilizations, but in its opposite. What's the opposite of the clash of civilizations, which is that we want to work so that individuals and nations can see one another and recognize each other's values, that they can form a network together for a better world without renouncing or denying anything that is fundamental to their values, their culture, ethnicity, religion, or identity in any way at all.
Zakali.
Here I have a screen in front of me that says waiting for network input. I think, therefore, that probably there is some network output. And until we have the full network output and input, I'll just say something about the program of the GenFest for those who maybe don't know all the details. So, obviously, the GenFest started today, Friday the 6th of July. It started at 8 o'clock in the morning in Manila with something called Explo, which is a cross between an exposition and an exploration, a kind of interactive exhibition on human history, talking about human history in the context of going towards being one family all over the world. Then now we have the 4 o'clock program of the opening of the GenFest, looking at the different borders that exist in the world today. Obviously, one of the borders is can be technology. We've got technology that unites us in an incredible way. And then, you know, there is also the fact that there are those who have and those who don't have. And we need to make sure everyone is connected. So then this evening in Manila, which is 2 o'clock or so in Western Europe from where I'm speaking, we have a concert, a music festival prepared by the young people from Asia. So the next part of the GenFest is Saturday, tomorrow. They have workshops and forums in the morning. And then after lunch, there is something called Hands for Humanity, which are 12 different activities, solidarity activities, linked to care for people and the needs of the city of Manila. Then we move on to the early evening program, which we too will follow, and that's the Time Out. Time Out is a prayer for peace.
There are physical borders for a number of reasons: geopolitical, economical, for whatever reason. But we hold each other in our hearts where there aren't any barriers. We are one people and we want a united world. For people who have ever had the privilege of looking down upon our planet from the view of outer space, they often speak of this overview effect, this cognitive shift in their perception of human life here on Earth. Because from up there, there are no borders. The international lines and boundaries that we've developed vanish. They're invisible and, quite frankly, non-existent. The rationale for why we continue to engage in the various conflicts that constantly divide humanity become small. There's an astronaut who's even said that from up there, it's crystal clear that on Earth, we are one humanity. Thank you. This next song
desert on both sides of the borderline, to the same beauty of the mountains. Winds of suspicion feel.
Hi, Cheska. How are you?
Oh, I'm good. Wow, you can be at FC now. Wow. So, Jaime, tell me about your hometown.
Yes. You know where El Salvador is it?
Kinda, but maybe you could clarify.
Well, El Salvador, it's a country in Central America. It's a small country, but rich in natural resources and indigenous history. However, El Salvador has been afflicted for many years by political instability, social injustices, and poverty, which has generated different forms of violence and social issues.
I'm so sorry that you're going through that. So how are you doing? How's your family doing? What did you guys do during these trying times?
Actually, 3 years ago, my family and I were thinking about leave our country. But after talking together about what we should do, we decided to stay.
What? Hold on. I'm sorry. Did you just say you decided to stay?
Yes.
Were you guys out of your mind?
Maybe.
Why did you decide to do that?
Because we think that we can make a change. Try to be a light in this dark place and in these dark times.
Wow, so that is how you created your project.
Yes. Actually, we, with a Youth for United World in El Salvador, launched a campaign called Change Your Square Meter. that also could be change your square foot. This means build peace in our own local space.
So what kind of activities do you have in Change Your Square Meter?
Youth for Another World involve other people for try to build a better environment for a local park, like painting walls, cleaning the street, collecting rubbish, and install trash bins. We also launched a book campaign, which intends to send books to towns with high student absence rates.
So what you're trying to say is, with these small activities, you are able to change, make a difference in your own area. Wow, that is truly inspiring. Do you have any advice for anybody who wants to practice changing your square meter?
Yes. Maybe we are not able to change our country at once, but a square meter, we can make a change.
All right, let's give Jaime a round of applause. You know what? I just had this brilliant idea. Why don't we practice changing your square meter right here, right now? How does that sound?
Sound good,
man. How does that sound, everybody? You want to join me in the audience?
Yes, let's go.
Take it away, Gio and Anna.
Thank you, Jaime, so much. This really inspired us to change our square meter.
Why don't we do it right here, right now, as Cheska said? Yes. So let's play this game we like to call as musical chairs.
Okay, tell me more about it.
Okay, first we have to group ourselves. Row A and row B is one group. Can you show it to us, Cheska, Lewis? Where are you?
Okay.
Here. Hello. Hello. Yes.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
Go ahead, Lewis.
This row
is one group, and also this row and this row, one group.
All right. Is that clear to everybody else here?
Yes. So stand up.
Stand up, yes. Guys.
Okay. So now we know our groups. Row A, row B, one group.
Everybody,
come on.
This is the rule. You have to listen very carefully. When the music plays, you move clockwise. How do we do that, Anna?
Okay, so the first row goes to your right, and the second row goes to your left, in a way that you end up walking in circles. Okay, so group two by two rows, and then walk in circle.
Yeah, as the music plays, you move clockwise, and as the music stops, you also stop. Freeze.
Are you ready?
Okay, let's try it. Okay,
let's
can
we
do it? Okay,
stand
music
up.
On. To go beyond the borders, we to free ourselves.
Yeah.
All right. Stand up.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Now that the music has stopped, everybody listen up. I want the people in the front row or row A to face the person behind you.
Okay.
Yes.
So there you go.
Row B, face the person in front of you still. Okay.
Okay.
So you got new friends now,
and,
yes?
And now, listen, please. Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Further to change our square meter.
Okay, maybe we can throw some compliments to your new friends. How can we do it, Louis?
For example, Louis, I really like your skin.
Thank you, Jessica. I really like your heels.
Okay, throw the compliment.
Lil O Gio, you're so nice.
You look beautiful.
Oh, look at this. So much. All of these positive words. I love it.
Wow, good energy.
So much love in this room. All right, good job, everyone. We just made you proud. Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, we can now go back to our seats.
You can now go back, yeah. Can we put some music to that while we're going
and
back?
To now let me get on the border. We've seen free ourselves. Fear and open limits. We might say ourselves. Go beyond your borders. It's a goal we can reach.
My name is Ezid Nduwayez from Rwanda.
I'm Jean-Paul Muhanuzi from Burundi. In 2015, while waiting for a bus to return home, I met a young man at the bus station. He lived in one of the most dangerous areas of the city with his brother. I felt that it was a risk for him to walk alone in that area at night. I suggested he spend the night at my place. The bus didn't come, so eventually we decided to walk home. On our way, we were attacked by 6 men. They beat us up and they threw me into a canal. I was dead. I was unconscious about an hour. When I woke up, I realized that I couldn't move my body from my chest down to my legs. I screamed, then this new friend came to help me. He was not as badly hurt as I was. With the help of some people, I was taken to a nearby hospital. The love I had shown to this new friend saved my life. If we hadn't been there, I would have died. He had returned my generosity with love. After a week in the hospital, I was transferred to Kigali, a Jewish town in Rwanda. There, the doctors discovered that I had a serious spine injury. I had to stay in bed and I couldn't move because I was paralyzed and in so much pain.
I felt his pain as if it was in my own. However, I was amazed that he kept smiling after what happened to him. I would say that he radiated a light in that very difficult situation. When I saw him, I knew that he needed someone to look after his needs. Jean-Paul's close friend from his country stayed and cared for him for a month, but he needed to go back to school, and I offered to take his place. It wasn't easy because I had a small job that helped me financially. I decided to leave my job and help Jean-Paul full-time. My family couldn't understand how I could leave my job for this. But because I was determined, they let me go.
After a month, I had an operation. The doctor told me that I would never work again. In a month and a half, we had to move to a rehabilitation center so that I could start my physical therapy. The therapy was very hard, but I didn't give up. I exercised with all my strength, and in the end, the miracle happened. I started to work with 2 crutches, and within a year, I could work with 1.
Throughout the time we spent together, Jean-Paul always was smiling. He gave us joy and hope that he recover one day. So for me, I was like, I'm happy for this, and he gave us the strength to go ahead and try to look after him with full love, with all my heart. By the help, by the unit of Youth United World of Rwanda and Burundi, we tried to overcome all sufferings together. and going beyond our borders.
It's been a year I left the rehabilitation center. I thank God he kept me strong and gave me the courage not to quit. I had also been able to forgive those who beat me up. I'm convinced that forgiving them has not only given me peace, but in some way helped me to recover fast. I want to thank my friends and the family of Youth for a United World who helped raise the money to pay for my treatment.
After all the time we spent together, God rewarded me. I received the funding to go back to school, and I got a new job which is better than the first one. Above all, I really thank God who helped Jean-Paul to recover. And now you see he's just in good condition. For Lily, thank you just to take your time to hear us. Thank you.
Here is Kota, a friend of mine, a Buddhist who comes all the way from Japan. Kota, how do you say hi in Japanese?
Konnichiwa!
Konnichiwa! Now let's listen to his experience of how he went beyond his border.
Hi, my name is Kota Fukui. I come from Tokyo and I'm a Buddhist from the Risho Kosekai, a lay Buddhist movement in Japan, which was founded by Nikkyo Niwano. 2 years ago, I decided to study at the seminary school of Risho Kosekai. There, I learned to express what I felt as it came to my mind. Along with the Buddhist teaching, the interdependent arising, which taught me that my actions and my way of seeing the world could influence things for many years to come. Having learned these teachings of the Buddha when I was a university student, I thought it would be enough to put them into practice in a superficial way. In time, I became a superficial Buddhist who seemed gentle to people on the outside, but actually looked down on people on the inside. I suffered because of the contradiction of these two realities within me. That is why I decided to study at the seminary school to try to be a more sincere and honest Buddhist in both thoughts and actions. In order to understand where the suffering came from, I began observing my own thoughts and reactions whenever I met new people or experienced daily events. Doing this almost every day, I came to recognize that what my heart really desired was my own mother's attention and praise. Growing up, my parents were always absent at home, and I felt alone with my sister, who I felt responsible for. I subconsciously reject having to rely on them, which made me all nervous and unable to express myself. So I asked myself what I should do. Then I found the courage to express everything I felt. I realized what I needed was to be able to talk sincerely to my parents without getting nervous. And I wanted to tell them how much I love them. One night, I was reciting the word of Buddha. It seemed to me that his words were my mother's words telling me. I just want you to be happy no matter what you can or can't do. I couldn't stop the tears rolling down my cheeks. That same night, I opened up to my mother and apologized for being blind to her love and promised to be respectful. She was very accepting and understanding. In that moment, my pain, which had come from wanting her recognition and praise, disappeared. And the whole world seemed to be full of light. Through this experience, I learned that by changing my perspective, the world can look different. Even if things around us don't change for the better, our way of looking at them will naturally change and become like that of the Buddha's own reverend Nikkyo Niwano. Of course, other causes of suffering are still deep within me, and I want to focus my attention there. But in the end, I was able to really understand the Buddha's teaching of interdependent arising. I have become aware of this thanks to my faith. And I want to share my joyful experience with as many people as possible so we can all work together along the path towards happiness. Thank you very much.
bussare a tante porte per trovare lavoro, strane selezioni che fanno loro, caselle da sbarrare, quiz pulsanti e qualcuno che ti passa sempre avanti. Essere ingegnere è proprio duro, non riuscire a immaginare che sarà il tuo futuro. È un mestiere qualificato che ha pochi sbocchi sul mercato, e dopo 2 anni ti domandi ma perché ho studiato. Se sei nei miei panni ti senti quasi disperato. Finire a vendere l'enciclopedia, un lavoro è buono qualunque so sia. Cercare da affibbiarlo alle casalinghe a forza di lusinghe. E mi ricordo lacrime che scendevano mentre guidavo. Io non avevo niente nelle mani. Con quelle lacrime usciva dal cuore mio, con quelle lacrime usciva il mio canto a Dio. Ma non ricordo se fosse dolore o la gioia di avere per me soltanto Dio. Quando ecco che una grossa società mi fa fare un colloquio che alla fine va. D'accordo ingegnere, lei è preparato e l'assumiamo perché è più indicato. Mi parlarono con fare gaio di gettate di inerzia e di canne d'acciaio. E appena io riuscii ad orientarmi, io capii che costruivano armi. E dopo 20 anni hai capito per cosa ho studiato. Se sei nei miei panni ti senti che sei arrivato. Sì, d'accordo che io sono cristiano, ma che c'entra se io accetto, non c'è niente di strano. Questo è proprio il lavoro mio e anche in questo ambiente posso amare Dio. E mi ricordo lacrime che scendevano mentre guidavo. Io non avevo pace dentro me. Che devo fare? Io non so, io non vedo chiaro. Che devo fare di questo che è il mio lavoro? E mi ricordo l'amore di amici, un amore che luce per me. Ed era Dio. È pazzia l'idea di rinunciare a quest'unica proposta che mi può realizzare. Di gente che lavora con le armi in fondo, ce n'è tanta in questo mondo. Io mi dissi tanti lo faranno, lo so, come loro guarda loro sistemarmi potrò. Io mi dissi tanti lo faranno, lo so, ma io no. E mi ricordo lacrime che scendevano mentre guidavo. Ancora una volta niente nelle mani. Con quelle lacrime usciva dal cuore mio, con quelle lacrime usciva il mio grazie a Dio. E più non era dolore ma gioia, la gioia di avere per me Lui. E mi ricordo lacrime che zampillavano pure dal cuore. C'era una gioia immensa dentro me. E non avevo perduto niente, certo io, ma avevo fatto un altissimo volo in Dio. Avevo tutto perché ero suo figlio, ero figlio di Dio, ero io. E mi ricordo, ricordo gli alberi che si inchinavano lungo la strada. Io mi ricordo il sole che illuminava. E non sapevo nemmeno che alla fine del viaggio mi attendeva un inimmaginabile messaggio. Era l'amore di Dio che guidava i miei passi ed io stavo con Lui, stavo con Lui. Yeah, yeah.
Salamà!
I always thought that the war was far from me. I realized instead that it's much closer than what I thought. I'm Tommaso, I grew up in Vicenza, a city in the northern of Italy, where I have lived a most peaceful life till now. In 2014, I went to Jordan in the Middle East, where I experienced firsthand the consequences of the war. I visited the refugees camp and I interact with people from Syria and Iraq
who had to flee from their own countries to save their lives. This experience changed my life and my perspective of the war. I felt inspired to go back to my country and create awareness about the nonsense of war. Together with a friend, which is Giovanni, that is also here, we started almost by a chance a project called Non dalla guerra. Our main goal is to educate people about the peace by showing them what war is and bringing war closer to the privileged people like me that have not experienced its atrocities. We tell our testimony regarding the reality we saw in a war-torn countries and how those conflicts are destroying societies, undermining people's hope, freedom, and possibility to build a better future. For us, it's not enough simply to participate in a reality when it's convenient, but rather to live it. The GenFest is not enough. Non dalla guerra is not enough. These are singular events. We must live peace, which is a need. The people are dying and suffering. I would like just to remind those people that nowadays are dying in Dara, which is a city in the south of Syria, mainly, that are bombing. I would like to remind them, and I would like to ask you to remind them now. Being young has not prevented us from carrying forward our ideals. We are still making a lot of mistakes, but understand well that this is part of the experience that we are making. We went up against challenges, and sometimes people that would make us question ourselves about what we are trying to do. But our commitment to build peace and denounce war has become a passion and part of our lifestyle. The most important thing is to respond with our own life by going out of our comfort zones to face the needs of humanity. I have realized that we, young people, can change the world. Our contribution may seem small, but it's fundamental in the construction of a more peaceful and more united world. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Young people from all over the world are united with us in these celebrations.
They are connected with us through our live stream at Youth for United World website, which is y4uw.org/live. Mom is watching. Hi, Mom.
Hello. Also, you could check out Youth for United World's Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter accounts for updates on what's happening inside and outside of the World Trade Center.
Okay,
wait, I have an idea. Why don't we, all of us here, send some of our love back to everyone watching?
Okay.
Yes, we can do that.
Let's call the cameraman to go the biggest video greeting ever.
Oh. You guys up for the biggest video greeting ever? Yes.
Okay.
Let's call on our cameraman.
Kuya Jeff.
Where's and Kuya Oman.
Jeff? Where is Jeff?
Oh, okay.
Our cameraman's actually named Kuya Jeff.
Yeah.
Are you Jeff?
Hi, Jeff. All right. Wait, hold on.
What should we say? Like hi?
I think, well, since we are in the Philippines, maybe we could add a little bit of Filipino flavor or something. So instead of a simple hi, let's bump it up a notch to Mabu. Hey!
Wow. Can
what
we
do
guys
it? Think, eh? Yes.
Let's try it. Let's
clever,
try it first.
Oh, I got it.
Let's try it. Come on. 1, 2, 3.
Mabuhay!
Okay. Stand up, everyone.
Stand up,
come on.
I think we should go a little lower.
Oh, yeah. We're going to go a little lower. Yeah. Let's all face the
Can
camera.
Can you all see us, Queen Jeff? Oh, we're on the screens. Yeah. All right. I gotta suck it in.
Okay. We say mabuhay in 3, 2, 1.
Mabuhay!
Woo!
watch it. Okay, so now a good friend of us sent us a letter. Let's listen what he has to say.
My dear friend, even in the depths of a prison cell, we must put love into practice.
This letter to me is so valuable, and so are the words of Kiara Lubich when she wrote,
I can imagine that all of you feel the burden that violence and terrorism place on home nations. Young people.
Like rain that gently penetrates into the depths of the earth.
Do you know that in the world right now, we have 66 walls dividing nations?
And 36 of them are in Asia.
That the gap between the rich and the poor is at its highest level since the past half century.
Wherein one of six adults suffer a common mental health problem like anxiety and depression.
We are in age where we are more connected than ever, but we see isolation and loneliness.
We see relationships between friends, neighbors, and families falling apart, crumbling because of pride, miscommunication, and unforgiveness.
We see all these borders.
But what can we do?
Should we keep watching the world continue in this way?
Or can we change the course of history?
Do we remain as spectators?
Or to be the first to take action?
We learn that changing our perspective, the world is immediately a much better place than it was.
That by changing ourselves step by step,
of prejudices, I've learned that I can share many things with my neighbor, despite there being a political border.
Going beyond social violence, I learned that maybe I can't change society right away, but I can make a change square meter by square meter.
Going beyond physical border,
the sunlight beats the sky where the
countries.
Beyond every border, geographical, national, cultural, religious, what are the skills needed in order to build a more united world? Let's identify our strengths by filling up our online questionnaire that you can see on the screen.
And now, we would like to make a special mention of our friends from the Milonga International Volunteering Program, which allows you to carry out periods of volunteering service from 1 to 6 months in different continents. To find out more, visit the Milonga booth outside the hall. And now, we finally eat.
Wait. Let's hear first our theme song, Beyond All Borders!
And then we eat!
We go beyond.